Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. I hope you're all well. Today we're going to do something a little bit different. I'm back in RaceRoom and I'm in one of my all-time favourite GT1 cars, the Saleen S7R. We're going to start from the back of the grid though today. We're going to do 6 laps, standing start from Sepang, and we're going to see what this 7-litre V8 can do. Hopefully we can cut through the pack. Not sure what to expect at the start. No doubt I'll leave most of my tyres behind. We're off. Okay, so we wheeled that GT on, that wasn't too bad. Pass that side. Not sure what's in the braking room here. Nice and clean there. That's a lot cleaner than I expected. As it comes through Pankow for the first time. Getting jostled about a little bit, but not too bad. There's the car park at least. Flood on the gas now as we come down to lane 4. Do exactly the same thing here, might stay out wide. Nice. Can't stay out, can't go out too wide as we come around here. Might leave it in third as we hit Gen 10. Back on the gas. Hard on the brakes, back down to third here. As we head into Bird's Eye. Got a hard braking corner here. Oh, that Roush has been tagged. As we come up to Kenyere, one of the most difficult corners for me. We're not an overly technical corner, but I just can't see it coming. Okay, set the car up here. As we come into Sunway, I don't think we've got a chance to do a pass. The cars are too far ahead. Drop it down to second. As we come onto Penang. The Saleen tries to kill me. Come up to the main hairpin now. Pretty cool circuit layout when you think about it, because they can split the circuit in half from this point and they're almost exactly the same length, the two halves, so it can cater for actually two actual separate races at the same time. Okay, so we're heading down corner 1 pan out. Okay. Might have some time under brakes there. Again. Side by side. I think that's a Roush anyway. Hard on the brakes, catch up to this GT. Never get genting right. Always struggle with it. Anyway, down to third. Come to Virgil again. Not the tail of that GT. Coming up to Kenyere. Tyre squealing. Big V8 just wants to kill you. With a cheeky dive there, make up another spot. So we get a couple of spots. Not too dangerous in there as we come to the hairpin again. Oh, overshot that big time. That was horrible. Sorry guys. We're up to ninth. Well, no one's died yet. Let's see what we can do here. Wow. I'm really struggling with that braking marker there. That's not being silly, I think. See if we can make some legitimate racing passes instead of dive bombing. Got a better line out of there. That was a bit better. Cleaner pass. So we are up to fifth. Third lap. AI set to 100 again, as it was yesterday. That was a better hairpin. No stupidity. Okay, let's go. So Kuala Lumpur, first opened in 1999, and it had held up to 2017, both F1 and MotoGP championships every year, all the way up to 2017. Obviously F1 stopped in 2017, MotoGP still held there. The lap record, they park it in the engine of Roush. That record is 134 by Sebastian Vettel in the 2017 Ferrari. The MotoGP record in a race, anyways, is basically 2 minutes on the dot. I know that Lewis Hamilton's actually got the outright lap record, which is 130, but not during the race. It's a pretty cool circuit. I think so, anyway. It has some of my prerequisite elevation changes, which obviously makes Kenya up here one of the difficult corners, because you're heading slightly uphill and you can't actually see the corner until it's on you, or you're on it. Saleen up ahead. Go, mate, go. Into the third. Whew. 202. Let's see if we can get a 201. That was a big dive bomb. Luckily there was no contact, except for him trying to push me out the way then. Tyres squealing. Key to this circuit, I think, is you've got to basically use all of it. Because it's the same as any real racing circuit, you need to use as much as possible to get the most out of the car. Maybe not that much. Verger. all over you, mate. Come on. Come on. That was a little bit better. He's all over the place. Whew, we've done it. One lap to go. Okay, no mistakes. Let's get a nice clean lap in for the last one. The last time. Here we go. Pencore down. Relatively clean. This long car. So yeah, Saleen, one of my favourite ever GT1 cars. Just one and one and one. Engine that was reliable, powerful, one everywhere. Nürburgring, Le Mans, the lot. 2017, Saleen did a 10-year anniversary LM model. It was released in the US and it was absolutely insane. 1300 horsepower from a twin turbo 7-litre V8. They only made 7 of them. If you're lucky enough to get your hands on one of those, wow. It's about as close as I'll ever get something like that. Oh, tyres. That's a bit of a messy last lap. Sunway for the last time. Could have been the last time then. Here we are, down Penang. Still braking far too early. I shouldn't be accelerating as I'm coming through the apex and across the line. There you go, awesome. Well, I hope you enjoyed that, guys. I really enjoyed that. If you did, give it a like, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell, and I'll surely be uploading more content soon. Thanks, everyone. Bye.